Fight fans all over the world, it's Daddy P on the corner, in the corner. What? Boxing, listen. Hey, Devin Alexander and Andre Berto, hey, they got the head nod for the undercard of Garcia versus Easter that's happening on July the 28th. Listen, y'all know who both guys are, man. Andre Berto, welterweight champion in the past. Devin Alexander was the unified junior welterweight champion and a welterweight champion. Both these guys were something else in their heyday, man. Y'all know a little bit. Andre Berto actually was an Olympian. You know, he represented Haiti in the 2004 Olympics. Yeah, man, this young man is, you know, coming up was the real deal. And, you know, a pivotal part in his career, he fought Victor Ortiz. And, man, that was a good fight, man. Victor Ortiz and Andre Berto, man, if anybody who listening, if you have never saw that fight, you need to go on YouTube and look it up. I'm telling you, Victor Ortiz versus Andre Berto, that was a good fight, the first fight. Now, you know, Andre Berto lost the first fight, and then they fought again, like, what, in 2016 or something like that? They fought, and Andre Berto got his get back, you know? So he avenged his loss to Victor Ortiz. But yeah, that was a good fight. That first fight was off the chain. And hey, to some people it could have went either way, but Victor Ortiz pulled it out, you know. But then, like I say, Andre Berto got his get back a couple years ago. And you know, everybody thought both those guys was finished though. But they came back and did it, and that kind of was Berto's portal back into boxing. You know, after he got his get back from Victor Ortiz, it was a good selling point for him, you know what I'm saying? And because he had lost to Mayweather, you know, I think what that was the year before in 15. When was that he fought Mayweather? I think it was 15. He fought Mayweather, and his portal back into the sport, you know, he beat Victor Ortiz, and it was a good selling point for him to keep fighting. And, you know, y'all know he fought, what that was, last year he fought Sean Porter. And you know, that fight, I'm going to tell you, I ain't going to even really go there, man. Y'all know what happened with Sean Porter and Andre Berto. It wasn't a good thing for Berto. And Berto really didn't look tremendously bad. He looked kind of old in there. But, you know, Sean Porter, it was a bully fight, you know. But anyway, I ain't gonna stay there too long. Andre Berto, y'all know who he is. Devin Alexander, y'all know who he is. He had a little bout with you know, prescription drugs, but he got himself together. He came back. He fought last year. He came back, he fought earlier this year. He also fought Victor Ortiz, who, hey, like I say, everybody thought was done. But Victor Ortiz, it was a good showing of himself against Devin Alexander earlier this year. But they fought to a draw. And a lot of people felt like Devin Alexander did enough to win the fight. I'm going to tell you, me personally, I thought Devin Alexander did enough to win the fight. But, you know, hey, it is what it is. Anyway, Devin Alexander, he, you know, with the fight with Victor Ortiz, the judges had it 115-113 for Victor Ortiz, so they had it close for Victor Ortiz. Of course, one judge had it 114-114, you know, for a draw, and one judge had it 118-108 for Devin Alexander. So the judge that had it for Alexander had it wide. The judge that had it for Ortiz had it slim. And, you know, of course, one judge had it, you know, a draw. Copy box numbers, though. Devin Alexander landed 32% of total punches. He landed 155 of 485. And Victor Ortiz landed 25% of total punches, only landing 137 of 550. But, you know, Devin Alexander looked pretty decent in that fight. He looked sharp enough to compete, you know what I'm saying, at the welterweight level again and say, hey, look, I'm here to mix it up. And I'm going to tell you, I'm not sure. Andre Berto, I believe Devin Alexander is like 31. Andre Berto is like 35. And, you know, fighters fight well past 35. But the fights that Andre Berto has been in, you know, the type of fights, he done been knocked out twice. He got knocked out by Jesus Soto Carras. He also, and you know, the other knockout, like I say, I ain't gonna go there with the Sean Porter thing. That was a TKO, whatever. But, you know, just the type of fights Andre Berto has been in and the injuries he's had, man, you know, he does have miles on him. And I'm gonna tell you, I don't know if now at this level, I mean, it's a good fight for him, you know, to see whether he still got enough in the tank to compete. Because Devin Alexander's still trying to get himself together. But Devin Alexander, to me, proved that he could compete, you know, against Victor Ortiz. Now, what people are telling you, now look, Andre Berto, when he fought Victor Ortiz, now, even though it was a couple years ago, he knocked him out. But every year, when you get a certain age, after you come from your peak, after you are no longer peaking, every year you are different. Your body is different. You know what I'm saying? When you get up past like 32, so just because he knocked him out a couple years ago, he knocked out Victor Ortiz when he got his get back. Andre Berto did. You know, that was a couple years ago. So you can't really go on that. But at the same time, you know, Andre Berto did knock Victor Ortiz out. And Devin Alexander, to me, he ain't struggled. He, you know, he was a good showing to himself, but Victor Ortiz showed as well. But Devin Alexander, to me, showed that he is here and he can compete. Andre Berto, I think he can compete, but I don't know what level he can. I think Devin Alexander, man, after another fight, you know, after this fight and maybe take another fight, I think he'll be ready to compete at the highest level, you know. But Andre Berto, I think his days of competing at the highest level are well past him, you know what I'm saying? And I think really this is a fight that can catapult Devin Alexander into something big, you know, depending on how he looked. And I'm trust me, I don't want to sound condescending. Hey, I respect these fighters, man. They keep lacing them up and getting in there. And I like Andre Berto, but I'm just being real. And the thing is, I really don't want to see the man get hurt. But I think this is not well out of his range. You know what I'm saying? I think this is something, you know, he can come in and do some work here with Devin Alexander. But anyway, man, hey, this Daddy P on the corner, in the corner boxing. This fight is going down, like I said, on the undercard of Garcia and Easter on July the 28th. So, hey, man, like I say, I'm going to do some more videos before then, but it was just kind of intriguing to me to see that these boys got the nod to do it on there. I'm glad to see Devin Alexander coming right back. Like I say, he fought earlier this year. He's showing that he's hungry and he really wants to compete. He's taking his career, even at this stage, hey, he's taking it seriously. So, hey, big up to both guys. This Daddy P on the corner, in the corner boxing. Subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell icon so you can be notified every time it go down. Go ahead and slap that like button for me. This Daddy P out of there.